सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
The human birth is given only to claim or to discover one's own Ananda Swarupam. That is the only purpose of human birth. So, as I am born in a human body form, I have to achieve that, accomplish that in this life. How you accomplish, with what effort you accomplish, is your choice. But you have to claim for that Ananda I am. Since you are desirous of peace, Ananda, security, you cannot avoid this. Every human being, some fortunate human beings get right direction, scriptural study, Guru Kripa, Shastra Kripa, and they claim this truth. For that you need Ishwara Anugraha. All people cannot get why, because lack of Ishwara Anugraham, lack of Bhakti. That is why Ishwara Bhakti is tremendously required to get this desire towards, to own up this Ananda Swarupam, to prevent my struggle for Ananda. My struggle in my life to get peace, Ananda, to end up this, I need Ishwara's grace. Once I get Ishwara's grace, Ishwara provide Guru, Ishwara provide such a Guru with Shastra. And Ishwara provides such a Guru with Shastra that teacher will teach you with compassion. All these are important if you are desirous of. Therefore, the reality you are giving to this unreal, seeming real universe is the cause, not claiming I, the Jivatma, and Brahman. I am not able to claim in spite of listening many years because lukewarm interest with regard to this goal of human life. Once there is a lukewarm interest, you know, lukewarm interest, there is only mumukshutvam but not tivra mumukshutvam. Intense desire for moksha or liberation. That is required. Tivra mumukshutva, intense desire. When you feel hungry after 2-3 days, you are searching for food, tivra akanksha for food. You search somehow or other, I want to get it, otherwise I will die. How much effort you put at that time when you are hungry? You put lot of effort. Like that, you must be moksha hungry person. Tivra mumukshu is one who is hungry of liberation, moksha. I am so much desirous of this liberation, moksha. I will tell you what is moksha. Dukkha nivritti. Freedom from sorrow. I don't want sorrow at all. That is called moksha iccha. No one can say, I don't want moksha, I don't have moksha iccha, no one can say. Because no one can say, I don't want freedom from sorrow. Yes? No one can say, I don't want freedom from sorrow. Anyone can say? Everybody want to say, I want freedom from sorrow. That I want freedom from sorrow is called moksha iccha. That's why, according to me, all are mumukshus. All are they may not be Tivra Mumukshus, they may not be Tivra Tara Mumukshus, Tivra Tama Mumukshus, but they are Mumukshus. Desire for sorrow-free life is called Moksha Ichcha. Moksha means what? Freedom. To be free. To be free from what? You want to be free from Ananda? Or you want to be free from joy, Sukham? None of us want to be free from Sukham or joy or Ananda. Everybody want to be free from Dukham. That is why everyone is a Mumukshu. Then we come to know that Mumukshutvam you intensify more and more. Why you are seeking for that freedom from sorrow? Because you have given the reality to this and the middle line. What is those three statements? What is the third, second statement? Jagan Mithya. And the Jagan Mithyani, we have made it as Satyam. Jagat Satyam, Shariram Satyam, Manas Satyam, all are Satyam. Once they are Satyam, your Bandham is also Satyam. Bondage, because body has got umpteen doshas, old age, death, disease, hunger, thirst, so many problems body has got. Mind also has got lot of, you know, oppression, suppression, depression, so many stress, tension, anxiety in the mind. It also has got lot of defects. In the world, you see how many defects are there. So many defects. Water problem, electricity problem, mosquito problem, air pollution, water pollution, all problem, problem, problem. Whatever is having problem intrinsically, whatever is having dosha intrinsically, you are giving lot of importance to that. Body, mind, world, you are giving such a respect, such a reality. To that is why we are all having sorrow. Because you are giving reality to that jagat, mithya, shariram, mithya, manas, therefore you are thinking you have sorrow. Therefore, Shastra talks about six topics. Since those who are giving reality to this unreal world, they have to come out of this sorrow because they are giving reality. They want to come out of sorrow. Why they want to come out of sorrow? Because they are giving reality. Therefore, take out the reality. That's all. You take out the reality from them, your sorrow disappears. How to take out reality from the world, from the body, from the mind? How to take out reality? Because of ignorance you are giving reality. Therefore, remove ignorance, reality also goes away. Satyatva buddhi. You are giving satyatvam to this seemingly real world. You are giving satyatvam to seemingly real body. You are giving satyatvam to seemingly real mind. That is the cause for your sorrow. Not my words. These are all the words of scriptures. This is called diagnosis. You are diagnosing the problem where it lies. First diagnose the problem. Then start treatment. Without diagnosis and starting treatment, and don't know what is the disease, doctor is giving medicine. How doctor can give medicine without diagnosing the disease? That is why our Shastra and the Guru Vaidya keep the Shastra Aushadham in the hand, diagnose the problem of samsara in every human being. That diagnosis is very important. Then treatment works. Otherwise, it may work, it may not work. There is a problem. Therefore, diagnose the problem. Now, what is the diagnosis we have done? giving reality to the seemingly real world, body, mind is the cause for my sorrow. I will repeat. Giving reality to the seemingly real world, seemingly real mind, seemingly real body, we are giving reality and thinking it is satyam, 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 that is the cause for our sorrow. That is the cause we are not able to claim we are UAS. So remove that reality. Take out the reality. By what? Shravana sadhana. By listening to scriptures. That is called sadhana camp. What for sadhana camp? Sadhana camp is meant to discover that UAS. I am missing the UAS. Adhu kuda marakalayo. UAS na? Repeat. Uninterrupted ananda supply. I am missing it because of my ignorance. I am thinking I have sorrow, I am sorrowful. Badha, kashtam, dukkham, guilt, hurt, all these only because of one thing. I am attributing the reality to the unreal world. If I say unreal world, you are disturbed. That's why I use the word seemingly real world for some time. For senior students, we can boldly use the word unreal world. But some new students are there, we have to be very careful. How many world is unreal, body is unreal, mind is unreal, you are also unreal. Therefore, bye-bye, they will go away. That is why until I retain you and confidently you will not go out of that sadhana camp, I will continue that word seemingly real. Clear? Now, what Shastra does talk about six topics, I said, every system of philosophy accept this. I the individual am here. World is in front of me, Jagat. And some power, whether you call it as God or Shakti, some power is there other than the world and me. There is some power, God, Ishvara. Once I give reality to this world, there is bandha, bondage, because this world is giving problem to me, that bondage is there. So, Jiva, Ishvara, number 2, Jagat, number 3, number 4, bandha, number 5, moksha. Since you think you have bondage, I want freedom from sorrow. That thought is there, you are seeking for liberation, moksha, freedom from sorrow, moksha. All systems of philosophies, they accept this, including other systems, not only Advaita Vedantin, all other systems also. Now, how many systems are there? First, I will tell you. Vedanta, we have Astika systems and Nastika systems. Astika systems means those who accept God, Ishvara and Veda, one type of Astika systems. We are Astikas. You are all Astikas. Why you are all Astikas? We accept Ishvara is there, Veda we accept. We respect four Vedas and we respect Ishvara, we have Bhakti, God is the creator, created and as the universe, I accept, therefore we are all called Astikas. But there are some systems of philosophies, they say Vedas we accept but Ishvara we don't accept. They don't accept God. those people who don't accept God, they are all Sankhyas, Purva Mimamsakas. These are all systems of philosophy. They also talk about Jiva, Bandha, Moksha. They also talk about that. Jagat. Everybody has to talk about Jagat world because it is tangibly available with a lot of mosquitoes, virus, bacteria. So many things are there in front of me. No one can deny this world. It may be seemingly real and it is absolutely not real, but world is there. Everybody accepts. The Sankhya philosopher is a philosopher. He is having his own view. What is that? Veda I accept, but God I cannot accept. They are also Astikas only, because they are accepting Veda. Therefore we call them as Astika. But they are not accepting Ishvara, therefore Nastika. Therefore they are called Astika Nastika. 50% Astikas, 50% Nastikas. Enna kadavul illaiyen solren. Enna pandrathu? So they are called Puramimamsaka Sankhya, Nyaya philosopher also. Then Yoga philosopher accept Dvaita philosopher, Visishta Dvaitins, they accept Ishvara. Veda also they accept, Ishvara also they accept. Therefore, they are all come under Astikas. We the Advaita Vedantins and Dvaita philosophers, Visishta Dvaita, Iyengars, Vishishta Dvaita means Vaishnavites, and Dvaita Madhvas, Madhvacharya followers, Ramanuja followers, they accept Veda, they accept God also, they are all called Astikas. We accept Veda, Vaidikas, we are all Smartas, we are all called Smartas. So Dvaita Madhvacharya followers, Dvaitins, Astikas. Vishishta Advaitins, Ramanuja followers are also Astikas. And we don't say Sankaracharya followers, because we are not following, it is not a belief to follow. So this Advaita Vedanta also, we are known as Smartas. Smartas. What do you mean by Smartas? Smartas are those people, they go to Shaiva temple and Shiva temple and Vaishnava temple. Both they go and prasadam, this prasadam also they eat, that prasadam also they eat. They are called smart. Smart people. They are called smartas. So we are all smart. We don't have any hesitation. But some Vaishnavas, they never go to Shiva temple. Some Shaivites, they will never enter into Vaishnava temple. Okay, let them have their own practice. These are all called six systems of philosophy, is one group. Astikas, Astika Nastikas. We don't call them Astika Nastikas, we combine them also into Astikas. Paravale, Astika na irke Veda you are accepting, adhe podo. And surely we combine them Sankhya, Nyaya, Yoga, Purva Mimamsaka, Vaisheshika and Uttara Mimamsa. We are called Uttara Mimamsakas. అది తెలుసుకోము నమ్మ ఏ పార్టీయో తెలియను చిన్న పేరుకి ఇంత 21 ఘటబంధంలో పార్టీస్కి ఎంత పార్టీ అని ఆళ్ళకే పురియల ఇప్పో ఎది ఓటు పోడనోని తెలియల మ్యాంగోకి పోడనుమా రెట్టయలకి పోడనుమా కన్ఫ్యూషన్ చెన్నై చెన్నైలో చిన్న పేరుకి మ్యాంగోక రెట్టలేక హస్తంక బీజేపీయా ఎన్నో తెలియల యారు 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 కూడా ఎలయన్స్ అనే తెలియల సమ్ పీపుల్ అది మాదిరి కన్ఫ్యూషన్ వరకూడదు నమ్మ ఎంగిరుకోని నమకు తెలియను ఐ మే బి ఫాలోయింగ్ భక్త ఆఫ్ రామానుజ వైష్ణవ మతం ఐఎమ్ ఫాలోయింగ్ బట్ సిద్ధాంత వైజ్ ఆత్మ జ్ఞానం సేక్ వీఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఉత్తర మీమాంసకాస్ వ్యాసాచార్య శంకరాచార్య ఉత్తర మీమాంసకాస్ మీన్స్ వేద అంత భాగ దే ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ దట్ ఈస్ బ్రహ్మ సత్యం జగన్ మిథ్యా జీవో బ్రహ్మైవ నాపరః. సో దో సిస్టమ్స్ అండ్ ఆల్ వీ హవ్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఆల్రెడీ ఇన్ అవర్ క్లాసెస్ మెనీ టైమ్స్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ బ్రీఫ్ బర్డ్ ఐ వ్యూ. వాట్ అబౌట్ నాస్తిక సిస్టమ్స్? అది కూడా సిక్స్ సిస్టమ్స్. இந்த நாட்டிலே நம்ம நாட்டில் ஐ எம் நாட் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் இஸ்லாம் அண்ட் கிறிஸ்டியானிட்டி, அதெல்லாம் வெளிநாட்டு மதம், அது அப்படி இருக்கட்டும். இன் அவர் கண்ட்ரி இட் செல்ஃப் தேர் ஆர் சம் ரிலிஜியன்ஸ் கேம் வெரி மச் லேட்டர், தட் இஸ் புத்திசம், ஜெயினிசம், சார்வாக்காஸ். இன் புத்திசம் இட் செல்ஃப் தேர் ஆர் ஃபோர் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் புத்திசம்ஸ். ஒரே கன்ஃபியூஷனும் கன்ஃபியூஷன், எவரு நமக்கு இல்லை அவங்களுக்கு. They have lot of confusion with regard to what, why they are all called total Nastikas. They are, we call them Nastikas. Nastika means what? A person who never give respect to Vedas. They don't accept Vedas. Four Vedas they never accept. Who? All four types of Buddhisms. Srautrantika, Madhyamika, Yogachara, Sunyavada, people, all four types of Buddhism, I have elaborately explained in the last year Sadhana Camp, care of my either YouTube or my CDs, you can listen, elaborately we saw about them. These Buddhists, four types, they never respect Veda, they don't agree with the Veda, they don't accept the Veda. Therefore, where is the question of accepting God? They never accept God also. So, Nirishwaravadi. Sankhyavadi also Nirishwaravadi. But he is a Vaidika. Whereas the Buddhists, or even till today Buddhism is there in our country. He is, his birthplace, he is in Nepal, Lumbini. That is, Buddha is really Indian only. Bharatiya only, but he, his followers brought one system of philosophy, Buddhism, Buddha Matam, Bauddha Matam. Enna Bauddha Matam theriyuma? Many people know Buddha statue, Buddha and Vigraham and all people respect, and some people consider him as avatara also. But we respect him as a great Mahatma, great enlightened person, but his philosophy, whether he said or his followers said, we the Pura Mimam, Uttara Mimamsaka as Vedantins never accept. Vyasacharya negate them in his Brahma Sutra. Shankaracharya also negate all of them. Why? Because they are all Veda Bahyaha. They negate Veda, because Buddhism negate Veda, they criticize Veda. They never accept Veda, therefore they are all Veda Bahyaha. Whoever refute Veda, they don't have place in this country. We never revere them, their system of philosophy. Our people may do Namaskara to Buddha. The 10 points they may follow, 10 commandments, but we never accept his original, his disciples' system of philosophy, because it is against Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahma Ivan Aparaha. In the slokatke adella false. That's why you don't accept. They come under Nastikas. There are some other Nastikas called Jainism, Jaina Mahavira. They also don't accept Vedas. They are also come under Nastikas. They don't accept Ishvara. They don't accept Vedas. Therefore, we consider them as Nastikas. We respect them. But when philosophy comes, we have to be honest. Because there are fallacies. In Brahma Sutra, we saw that. Therefore, four Buddhisms and one Jaina. How many? Five. One more. Charvakas. Materialists, they say body is final, Atma, this alone is Satyam. There is no Sukshma Shariram, there is no Karana Shariram, there is no Pranamekosha, all those who saw. What is available for my perception, that alone is real. I don't accept all these systems, philosophies, Vedas, God and all, I don't accept. They are all called Bhautika Vadis. They are called materialists. Charvakas is a philosopher. Charvaka is a philosopher. Now at present, whole world is his party. Kavo, Pivo, Masakaro, why God all these Veda classes, sadhanas? Why? He says, Yavat jivet sukhan jivet. Charvaka philosophy. As long as you live, enjoy happily, go to 5-star hotel, 3-star hotel, no, 7, irukka? 7 would irukka? Okay. No, 10 would varumo theriyum. I used to think 7 stars, 5 star anna, 5 story building anna. I used to think like that. Okay, 7 story building anna, 7 star hotel, 5 story building anna, 5 star hotel. Adilya. Are there some speciality? So, people, they're all called charvakas. Kavo, eat, pivo, drink, enna, drink. Majakaro, kondatam, enjoy. Saturday, Sunday, jolly, jolly, enna. These are all called charvakas. Now, maximum people are in the society, charvakas. They never respect Vedas. Now, you see, 12 systems of philosophies, totally. In the 12, you divide into two, 6 one group, another 6 into one group. Astika 6, Nastika group 6. These are all basic lessons. But I want to give, just revise, very important, because until now in Upadesa Sahasri, Shankaracharya negated all 4 Buddhist philosophers. So, I am in runway now. I have not taken a takeoff. This is truly runway. Okay, apparanda takeoff. 6 Astikas, Puramimamsa, Sankhya, Nyaya, Yoga, Vaisheshika. We are Uttramimamsakas. 6. Uttramimamsaka, Puramimamsaka, Sankhya, Nyaya, Yoga, Vaisheshika. All are Astikas. 4 types of Buddhism, 1 Jainism and Charvaka. 6 put together Nastikas. Shankaracharya refute all of them. 11 systems of philosophies he has to negate. Not only Shankaracharya, we have to negate. Otherwise, wo bhi tik hai, ye bhi tik hai, sab chalta hai na. Puja Swami says, Dayananda Swami, wo bhi tik hai na, Buddhism also okay, Jainism also okay, Ramanuja matam also okay, Madhvacharya matam also okay, Advaita matam, Shankaracharya matam, it is not Shankaracharya matam, okay. People consider like that, wo bhi tik hai, ye bhi tik hai, nahi chalta hai. Only one thing can be right. And in mathematics, I always use this example. How many answers will be there for one sum? Enna sum, enna spelling sum? Ampa, S-U-M. And the sum, mathematics teacher, class, one sum, ethana answers there? How many answers are possible? Right answers? Only one. Not two, not three or four. Only one answer. Similarly, in the Vedas have given the truth, the reality to this entire humanity. They are given by Bhagavan. They are giving the truth, the reality to the world. Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. This is the truth. We, the Uttara Mimamsakas, follow this truth. This is the truth. Why they are all talking like that? For them, some system of philosophy, differently they say. Ishvara and other world is real for them. Ishvara is in Vaikuntha or Ishvara is in Kailasa. They are all real for Astikas, some other systems of philosophy. Some other systems, they say, we don't accept ellar shunyam dana. There is only shunyam, emptiness. Voidness, nothing is there. Na. One type of Buddhist is Shunyavadi. Nihilist is called. So after negating all of them, 11 systems of philosophy, then only you arrive at Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. without fighting with all other systems, because they are all giving false, fallacious philosophies. Therefore, they are wrong. They are wrong because of this reason. This philosophy is wrong because of this reason. This philosophy is also wrong because of this reason. இதெல்லாம் எஸ்டாப்ளிஷ் பண்ணி ஐ ஆம் ஓன்லி ரைட் யூ ஹாவ் டு எஸ்டாப்ளிஷ் வித்தவுட் எஸ்டாப்ளிஷிங் தட் டீச்சர் ஹேஸ் டு சே வை அதர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட் சம் இஸ் ராங் திஸ் இஸ் த ஸ்டெப் யூ ஹவ் டன் ராங் திஸ் இஸ் த ஸ்டெப் யூ ஹவ் டன் ராங் டீச்சர் ஹேஸ் டு சே ஆர் நாட் மை டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் வாட் இஸ் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் இன் த கிளாஸ் பாபா ஷி டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு டிப் யூனோ கிவ் பெயின் டு எனி ஒன் எனி ஸ்டூடெண்ட் Students, students, you are all right. Chalalama, a mathematics teacher. All 40 types of answers have come, one right answer. Can she put good, good, good for all? She has to teach that student where he committed mistake. Why he didn't get the right answer? Why this answer alone is right? Why his answer is wrong? Teacher has to say or not? You tell me. Teacher has to say why that student, third bench student, did wrong, that answer is wrong, why the answer is wrong, what he did, what is the mistake committed by that student, the teacher has to say. Then only she can say, my answer alone is correct, she can say. Otherwise she cannot teach, all answers are okay, the teacher will be removed in the next day in the school. Teacher is supposed to teach the sum, a correct sum. Answer can be only one. Right answer can be one only. Wrong answers can be? What a intelligence. இதுக்கு வரைக்கும் பிஹெச்டி படிக்கணுமா? தேவையே இல்லை. Errors can be many. The right truth can be only one. That is called Advaita Vedanta. You cannot say they are wrong just like that verbally and escape. They will catch your hair. You have to say why that person is wrong. Where he has gone wrong. If that system, if you take, what are all fallacies will come? What are the difficulties? What are the consequences? Nee chollida poganum munnadi illana po mudiyadhu. I am only right, I am only right. A student who does a correct answer, he should know why this is only right. Just like by fluke he gets right answer? Accidentally he gets right answer? No. He is very clear, I should not do this step. If I do this step, this goes wrong answer. He must be very clear of every step. And he sees other books also, hey, you have committed mistake here. This is the wrong step. That's why you have got wrong answer. This student must know. Am I right or not? Among 40 students, one student has got right answer. This right answer student must have the capacity to see the other notes of the students where they have done the mistake also, he must know. That is the capacity of this student. The best student who got the right answer, he know next student committed a mistake, he look at the notes. Hey, you have committed mistake here. This is the wrong step. You should not do this way. If you do this way, how you get wrong, right answer? Therefore, correct that. This person knows. Who did correctly? That is called knowledge. Clear knowledge, doubtless knowledge. Why wrong is wrong also you should know. Why right is right also you should know. Why wrong is not right also you should know. Why right is not wrong also you should know. Then only he did on his own. Otherwise copy. He copy pannavale pannitana adenni proof. Correct thane. The teacher will ask. He should not say, he should not blink his eyes. I don't know in the step how it has come. That is not knowledge. That is not knowledge. A bright student is one. He knows what are all the wrong steps. A bright student is one who knows what is the right answer. Why I am alone right also he knows. When this is so natural with regard to a classroom and mathematics sum, why not 12 systems of philosophies with regard to Jagat, Jiva, Ishvara and Bandha, Moksha? When people are talking other systems of philosophies, when they are talking, all 12 students are there. Ippu namak Vedantamlo ethana student? 12 students, not in our class. In the Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, Bandha, Moksha, who are all discussing, they are all 12 in number. One person getting a right answer, all other 11 students are Sankhya, Nyaya, Yoga, Vaisheshika, Purva Mimamsa, Baudha, four types, Jaina, Charvaka, ellarku oru zero mark. And the, until 30th verse Shankaracharya did, when? Last year. Last year, Aama. Now also it is available on the YouTube, my last year summer camp classes. That's why I put in the last month itself, if anyone have not come to my class in the last sadhana camp, they can hear and come. And then I put that one. I do not know how many students have heard that, how many students have forgotten after hearing also. Doesn't matter. Anyhow, that system of philosophy, Shunyavada, was negated in the 30th verse. After negating that, then he enters into Advaitam. You cannot just like say that my Advaita Vedanta is right. Why you are right? Why other person is wrong also? Not to say others. You must be convinced. You must be convinced with your knowledge. For that sake only you have to study. So this is about all 12 systems of philosophy. We are in what system now? We are Uttara Mimamsakas. And the pair Navagachkon. Uttara na Veda Pura Bhaga, Veda Antara Anta Bhaga is called Uttara Bhaga. Upanishad Bhaga. According to Pura Mimamsakas, Uttara Bhaga, Veda Anta Bhaga is like a dry land, barren land. It is useless. Mahavakyas are useless according to him. Pura Mimamsaka. He gives utmost respect to Veda Pura Bhaga. Veda is divided into two portions, Karmakanda Bhaga, Upasana Bhaga, then Veda Vichara, Veda Anta Bhaga. So we are Veda Anta Bhaga, Upanishad Bhaga is the most important teaching in Veda, we say, who? Uttara Mimamsakas. Because it is Uttara, later portion. The Purva Mimamsakas says Karmakanda of the Veda is important. Upasana alone is important. Idella Vedantam, Brahma Satyam, Jagat Mithya, world is Mithya. These are all only stuti, only glorification. Don't go for Vedanta classes. This Veda Purva only important, they say. Therefore, we are all Uttara Mimamsakas, later portion of Veda, where it is said Brahma Satyam, Jagat Mithya, Jivo Brahma Iva Naparaha. In Madras University, if you see, there are people who study Vaishnavism, there are people who study Saivism, there are people who study Buddhism also, there are people, students who study Jainism also, there are students who study Purva Mimamsa also, there are students who study Uttara Mimamsa also, Advaita philosophy. You can take any system of philosophy to for master degree. We are not going to give any degree for you here. But we have to know. We are all Uttara Mimamsakas negating Buddhistic philosophies, philosophers' philosophy. We have refuted. What is that Buddhist philosophy we have refuted? I will tell you later. Before going to that, I have to put another foundation also. I have already given that. Once again, I remind. That is also basic. In third statement, what we saw, Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha, Aham Brahma Asmi. Okay, if you see 12 systems, we have understood. We are all called, Uttara Mimamsakas. Okay, we accept Ishvara, we accept Veda also, And we talk about this Mahavakya's Upanishadic teaching we follow. Clear? Now, in the third statement, Brahma, Aham Jeevatma Brahma Eva. This Aham, I am, when we say, who is this Aham? Who am I? I am Brahman. I am means what? I am. Shastra says, I am means there is a primary meaning and secondary meaning. Two meanings are there for I. I in not E-Y-E, but I, capital I. Non. In the non, there is a mixture. One is lower I, another is higher I. All my previous students, Vedantic students, very clear for all of you. For others students' sake also, I am telling. Because I am Brahman, when I say, I must be clear. Otherwise, I cannot say I am Brahman. So, based on that only, the all following slokas are going to come. That's why I have to give again that clarity. I am means Ahankara Chidabhasa is one part of I. Aham Chit is another part of I. I you can write and put two arrow marks. The rundu irukku madhulam. One is lower I and one is higher I. Another name for lower I is called Ahankara Chidabhasa. In Sanskrit, the technical term Vachyartha I. Vachyartha I. Primary meaning of I. Primary meaning. Non and chorna would primary technical popular meaning. Edivaru. Mano buddhi chitta ahankara. Adi or housewife, householder, student. In the I is called Vachyartha I. Lower I we call it as. Another portion of that I is higher I. That is called Lakshyartha I. Lakshyartha I. Another name for that is Chit. Here we said Chidabhasa. This is Chit. Higher I is called Chit. Lower I is called Chidabhasa. Lower I is called Vachyartha, higher I is called Lakshyartha. Put together I am. Whenever I say I am going to sadhana camp, it is Vachyartha I. I ate 3 idlis today morning. What? Chitta Chidabhasa. Ahankara Sahita body mind complex lower I. Brahma Chittaki, there is no mouth to eat idli, 3 idli. That is higher I. Lakshyartha I. So when we are talking in our life every day, I am a housewife, I eat, I walk, I do, I write, whenever we say, it is a lower I. Whenever I use body, mind, complex, with ahankara, I am female, I am a Tamilian, I speak Tamil language, I am a Brahmana, all this belongs to lower I. Caste, language, all these connections belong to lower I. Whereas higher I is called Turiya Atma Chit. Many of you are focused to Mandukya Upanishad. In Mandukya Upanishad, Pradhama Pada Vishwaha, even in Tattva Bodha also, Vishwa Taijasa Pragna, Pradhama Pada, Dvitiya Pada, Tritiya Pada, Waker, Dreamer, Sleeper. In the Waker, Dreamer, Sleeper, all are belong to lower I. Now you are all in waking state or some other waking state. You are Waker. You are called Vishwaha. Waker name you know. But Shastra gives you another technical name, Mandukya Upanishad name, Vishwaha. ప్రథమ పాద ఫస్ట్ పాద స్థూల శరీరాభిమాని ఆత్మా విశ్వ ఇత్యుచ్యతే కేర్ ఆఫ్ తత్వబోధ బేసిక్ లెసన్ సూక్ష్మ శరీరాభిమాని ఆత్మా తైజస ఇత్యుచ్యతే సెకండ్ పాద సూక్ష్మ శరీరం కారణ శరీరాభిమాని ప్రాజ్ఞః ఇత్యుచ్యతే థర్డ్ పాద శరీరత్రయ విలక్షణ సాక్షి ఆత్మచైతన్యం తురీయ ఆత్మా నా ఫోర్త్ పాద త్రీ పాదస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఆత్మ ఈజ్ తురీయ ఆత్మ నేను ఫస్ట్ పాద నా విశ్వ తేజస ప్రాజ్ఞ ఆర్ వేకర్ డ్రీమర్ స్లీపర్ ఐఎమ్ నైదర్ వేకర్ నర్ డ్రీమర్ నర్ స్లీపర్ యాజ్ చిత్ బట్ యాజ్ వాచ్యార్థ అహంకార ఐ నౌ ఐఎమ్ వేకర్ బట్ లక్ష్యార్థ ఐ స్టాండ్ పాయింట్ ఐఎమ్ తురీయ ఆత్మ వెన్ నౌ ఆల్సో నౌ ఆల్సో యూ హ్యావ్ త్రీ స్టేట్స్ ఎన్న ఆంధ్ర తెలంగాణ తమిళనాడుని చూడకూడదు త్రీ స్టేట్స్ ఎన్న వేకర్ డ్రీమర్ స్లీపర్ స్టేట్ ఇన్ ద త్రీ స్టేట్స్లో దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ బిలాంగ్ టు వాచ్యార్థ ఐ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ ఫర్ దీస్ త్రీ స్టేట్స్ స్థూల శరీరం వెన్ డామినెంట్లీ ప్రిడామినెంట్లీ వర్కింగ్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ యాక్టివ్ యు ఆర్ వేకర్ యు ఆర్ ఫుల్లీ స్లీప్ యు డోంట్ రిమెంబర్ యువర్ స్థూల శరీరం ఈవెన్ మైండ్ ఆల్సో యు ఆర్ ఇన్ డీప్ స్లీప్ యు ఆర్ స్లీపర్ స్లీపర్ అంటే స్లీపర్ ట్రైన్లో ఒక స్లీపర్ ఇక్కడ అది ఇల్లే స్లీపర్ అంటే సుషుప్త అవస్థ స్లీపింగ్ స్టేట్ సుషుప్తి అవస్థ ఇన్ డ్రీమ్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ నాట్ ఇన్ గాఢనిద్ర నాట్ ఇన్ వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ హాఫ్ ప్యాసివ్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ హాఫ్ ప్యాసివ్ హాఫ్ యాక్టివ్ ఇన్ వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ ప్యాసివ్ ఆర్ యాక్టివ్ హౌ మచ్ యాక్టివ్ సపోజ్ టు బి యాక్టివ్ హౌ మచ్ 100% అదర్వైజ్ యూ ఆర్ డ్రీమింగ్ ఆర్ స్లీపింగ్ అని అర్థం లే దట్ మీన్స్ డ్రీమ్ ఈజ్ దట్ స్టేట్ వేర్ ద మైండ్ ఈజ్ 50% యాక్టివ్ 50% ప్యాసివ్ స్లీప్ ఈజ్ దట్ వేర్ ద మైండ్ ఈజ్ 100% ప్యాసివ్ వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ ఈజ్ దట్ వేర్ ద మైండ్ ఈజ్ 100% యాక్టివ్ ఏమంటే సింపుల్ దాన్ని ఇది కింద మెడ్రాస్ యూనివర్సిటీ పోనుమా పిహెచ్డి తెరవయ్యా అన్ని తెరవాలి వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ ఈజ్ దాట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ నౌ డోంట్ సీ యువర్ టైమ్ ఇమాజిన్ 11:30 ఆర్ 12:20 టైమ్ యు ఆర్ ఫుల్లీ యాక్టివ్ నౌ యు ఆర్ ఇన్ వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ ద నోవర్ ఆఫ్ ద వేకింగ్ స్టేట్ The knower of dream state, the knower of sleep state is different from three states or not.
Yes.
The knower is always different from the known. This clip you are seeing, are you different from the clip or not? Yes. Swami, what a simple, simple questions you are asking. You are underestimating us. Ask big, big questions. No, no big question, simple question you answer. Because I am a simple teacher. I want simple answers. What is this in my hand? Clip. Are you different from the clip or not?
Yes.
What is in my right hand?
Pot.
Are you different from pot or not?
Yes.
The knower of the pot is different from the known pot. That means the knower is called subject. Pot is called?
Object.
Alpha. ఉంగలకెల్ల పిహెచ్డి కొడుకును ఇన్న వేదాంతంలో వాట్ ఈస్ ద రూల్ నౌ నోవర్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ సబ్జెక్ట్ నోన్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ నోన్ థింగ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ సబ్జెక్ట్ కెన్ నెవర్ బికమ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ క్లియర్ నౌ హూ ఈస్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ ఐఎమ్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ హూ ఈస్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ Whatever I see is object. Clear? I know my waking state. Are you aware of your waking state now?
Yes.
That means waking state is not yours. You are the witnesser Sakshi of waking state, dream state, sleep state. Then who am I? The higher I, Chit, Turiya Atma Aham, who is conscious of waking state also? Waking state idli also. Waking state hungry also, hunger also I am aware of, I am conscious of. And yesterday night dream also, I was as dreaming yesterday and I am conscious of that. And sleep also, I know I am sleeping, every day I am sleeping, I am conscious of my sleeping state, but not in sleep, because your mind is passive. But who is conscious of is different from what you are conscious of. Who is conscious of is different from what you are conscious of. Now I said you are conscious of this clip, I said. You are conscious of this pot, I said. That means what you are conscious of is different from you. Who is conscious of is Satyam, or what you are conscious of is Satyam. Who is conscious of is Satyam, subject. What you are conscious of is object. And this is what you are conscious of now. Pot. Pot comes under subject or object?
Object.
So who is conscious of pot? I, the subject. Now subject is Satyam or object is Satyam? Subject I am is Satyam. Object is not Satyam. So whatever you are seeing in this world, whole thing comes under object. Therefore, objective world is not Satyam. The subject observer experiencer is I, the subject experiencer is Satyam. World is cannot be Satyam. You said, you only said pot is not Satyam. I, the subject, experiencer of pot is Satyam, you said. Now put the whole world in the pot place. Whole world is like a pot. Now tell me, whole world is known by you or not? Stars, moon, ocean, trees, rivers, all these things are known to you. You, the subject. Whole world is object. That's why it is called objective world, prameyam. You are the pramada, the subject. This lower eye is the subject. Lower eye is the pramada. Lower eye is the knower. But what about chit? Chit bless the body, mind to know the world. Chit is not pramata. Chit is not the knower. Chit blesses the body-mind complex to play the role of subject, pramata, to know the world, prameyam, objective world. Now how many are there here? Objective world, the subject and the chit. The subject, body-mind complex, waker, dreamer, and lower I is unreal, ahankara I is blessed by higher I. Aham, chit, it is blessed. Therefore, I am Turiya Atma, the consciousness, bless the inert body with sentience. I, the chit, Atma, higher I, Lakshartha I, Turiya Atma, bless the mind, inert mind, with sentience. Then this mind body becomes sentient by getting Chidabhasa and start becoming Pramata, knower, Karta, doer, Bhokta, experiencer. This lower I, Karta, Bhokta, Pramata, these are all status I have given to body mind complex lower I. Who? The Chit Turiya Atma. Now, if non in the lower eye, Vyavahara, Vyavaharika prapancha, interaction, subject, object, all things are going on, relative order of reality. This I, lower I, vachyartha I, housewife I, householder I, holding the house, householder. I is called vachyartha I, primary meaning of the I. Whereas the Turiya Atma Chit is not a Pramata, nor Karta, or Bhokta. Turiya Atma Chit can never be the enjoyer, can never be the experiencer, can never be the knower of anything. Now, this waker, when you are waker, you are not sleeper and dreamer. When you are dreamer, you are not waker and sleeper. When you are sleeper, you are not dreamer and waker. Each one is exclusive. In dreamer, there is no sleeper. In sleeper, there is no waker. In waker, there is no dreamer sleeper. This is lower I. But all these three, which are exclusive each other, but one conscious awareness, awareer is there, who is aware of all the three. That is called chit, awareness. Now tell me, this exclusive vachyartha I you want to claim as yourself, ayaram gayaram. Enna thookam vanda waking kadaiyadu, waking vanda dream kadaiyadu, dream vanda waking kadaiyadu. And the mood state la irukkuradhena consciousness chit. I'm conscious of. Decide which one you want to claim yourself, lower I or higher I. In the room mixer da, put together only I am. You cannot physically unpurifiable. Okay. You cannot separate them physically. Can you separate intellectually or not? Intellectually you can separate. Clear? I am conscious of Sakshi Chaitanyam, witnesser of waking state. I am conscious of dream state, not now. I am conscious of sleep state. That consciousness is called Turiya Atma. Fourth Pada in Mandukya language, I am. That is my real nature. This is my Vesham. What is my Vesham? Vachyartha I, lower I, waker, dreamer, sleeper, I is my Vesham. Vesham is temporary or permanent? Drama, Vesham, is temporary or permanent? Temporary. Waker Vesham, dreamer is not there. Dreamer Vesham, waker is not there. Sleeper Vesham, dreamer, waker, they are not there. That's why they are all called Vesham. Therefore, you cannot say they are Satyam. What is Satyam? Absolute reality. Definition I gave in the first session. Trikala Abadhyam, that is Satyam. Three periods of time that which exists is Satyam. Now tell me, waker is there in sleep time? Therefore, waker must be unreal. Wakerhood must be unreal. Ahankara must be unreal. Sthula Shariram must be unreal. Yenna, sleep la sthula Shariramma onnume theriyadhu. A badhyam there, whereas the consciousness is not badhyam, not negated, it is there, very deep subject. Those who have studied Mandukya or any other Prakrana Grandhas advanced, it is easy for them, but it is your own waking dream state, sleep state. Enna kashtama iruka? Thungunadhu, every day we are sleeping, every day we are dreaming, every day we are in waking state. Adhikada, in the three states, keeping them as as a lesson, Brihadaranyaka, Swayam Jyoti Brahmanam, Antaryami Brahmanam, all these three states, the whole Vedanta runs, even Mandukya Upanishad, whole Mandukya Upanishad, these are the three, because known to unknown is easy. What is known? Waking state is known? Then adi kuda doubt. Waking state is known now. We are in Upadesha Sahasri class. Waking state is known. Dream state also is known. I dreamt yesterday, day before yesterday, also known. Sleeping state also known. I slept well yesterday. I don't know anything. I am not aware of anything. I slept well. That is also known. So all these three states are known to us. See how easy. Not someone's sleeping state, someone's dream state, someone's waking state. My own waking state, my own dream state, my own sleeping state. I am aware of. Therefore, it is easy. Through this study, it is easy to arrive at Chit, higher I. Known to unknown. Chit is not known to all of you, but waker is known to all of you. Dreamer is known to all of you. I am a dreamer, I am a waker, I am a sleeper. But you know sleeper, waker, no, and dreamer, but you don't know the witnesser of those waker, dreamer and sleeper. Therefore, you need a guru. To know the waker, sleeper and dreamer, you don't require it. You don't require a guru. But there is a Chit Chaitanyam, Sakshi Chaitanyam, Turiya Atma, who is Avasthatraya Vilakshanaha. Atma, Turiya Atma, that Turiya Atma you are. To say that you require a Guru. That is why Sadhana Camp. That is why Upadesha Sahasri class. Now we will read 30th sloka and 31st sloka, which I introduced in the last year sadhana camp. Then we go to 32nd sloka later. Page number 177, correct? 177, 30th sloka, repeat after me.
Mrishadhyasastu yatra syat. Tannashastatra no matah. Sarvanasho bhavedyasya. Moksha kasya phalam vada. Svayam nama, jnanam vātmānya devavam, vātmānya devavam, bhāva bhāvajñatastasya, nābhāvastvadhigamyate.
In this 30th verse, Shankaracharya asking a question to Buddhist. Buddhist, one type of Buddhist say everything is shunyam, everything is empty voidness. Now, if you say so, Shankaracharya asking, who is getting moksha? He is also talking about moksha. He is accepting moksha. But you see, everything is sunyam, everything is empty. How can you say a person getting moksha? The person must be there to say, I am muktaha, I got moksha. Chollrathu oru aadu irukkanuma vendama? Just like if you enter the hall first, nobody is there. What do you say? Nobody is there. To say nobody is there, somebody must be there. Is it not? If nobody is there, who can talk about nobody is there? In the hall, nobody is there. Can anyone talk about nobody is there? So somebody must be there to talk about nobody. That means nobody means somebody. Afternoon class, I'll explain. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.